So, hello everyone. Welcome to a short guidance video on trade guide signal stock selection. Right, so we are going to understand why, what is the importance of stock selection. So whatever the stocks you are seeing right here has been done only because of the stock selection which we have done under the stock selection tab. So whatever stocks you are selecting, you are seeing right now has been basically generated because of the stock selection which we have done under the stock selection tab, right? So as you can see right now, key how to do the stock selection, how, what is the logic of stock selection. Without the stock selection, there will be no stocks right here. Okay, so if you want to select your own stocks, you can also do that. For that, click on the stock selection tab right here. So once you click on the stock selection tab, the page will open in front of you. Make sure you're working on the latest, you are using the latest version of your browser. Okay, you are using the latest version of your browser. So which if you are not using the latest version, there might be some issues regarding the designing. So make sure you're using the latest version. First step is to select positional, then click on reset and click on save. So once you do the reset and save, all the stocks will get reset. So now there will be zero stocks right here under the position strategy. So there will be basically zero stocks. Okay, so let it load. It will take some time to load. So till the time it loads, we'll also see other things. So we can also do the stock selection of our own. So the stocks which I want to select on my own, that also I can select. For example, I want I press Control F button on my keyboard. So once I click on Control F button on my keyboard, now I am going to go to select the stocks. So what are the stocks that I'm going to select? For example, I have selected Control F and I want DCB Bank, so I'll type here DCB. Then click on, then you can select one more. Suppose I want one more thing, suppose Control F, and I select Infratrail. Right, if I want other stocks such as Infratrail and all GVL, I will select each and everything. So let's select that. So Infratrail I'll select right now. If I want HDFC Life, I can also select that. So Control F, I'll select here HDFC. So I'll select HDFC Bank and HDFC Life as well. Then I click on the save button. So what is the total save signal? So after that I click on the OK button. The total save signal is 4. Now whatever stocks I have selected, if I want to see it, so what are the stocks which I have selected? It is possible that I might forget that whatever the stocks I might have selected. So for that I click on the view selected tab right now. So from here you will get the entire view of the stocks which I have selected manually. So if these stocks have generated signal, then only it will reflect on your signal tracker page. Otherwise, it will not reflect on your signal tracker page, no matter how many times you have done the stock selection. So for that, I click on this refresh button. So once I click on this refresh button, so let's see out of the total 4 stocks which I have selected, how many signals it has generated. So let it load. It takes some time to load. So let's be patient and let's see how many stocks are generated, how many signals of those particular stocks have been generated. So as you can see, all the stocks has been, all the entire loading has been done. So out of this 4 stocks, all the 4 stocks have generated signal. That is why it is showing under your signal tracker page. Now you can use other options such as, again I click on reset and save, then I click on the OK button. Whatever the previous selection I have done has been reset. What happens is when I'm selecting all the stocks, when I'm selecting all the signals, the stocks which are non-performing, so which are basically highlighted in maroon color, that also gets selected, right? For example, see BSC. So the highlighted stocks are basically what stocks? The highlighted stocks are basically non-performing stocks. So these are the highlighted stocks, which are basically the non-performing stocks. So which are basically the non-performing stocks. So when you are selecting all the signals, the non-performing stocks also get selected. If you want to exclude that particular non-performing stocks, what you can use is, you can click on the button called as exclude non-performing. So that stock selection of that particular non-performing stocks will be removed. Okay. apart from that, you can also do a stock selection on the basis of a segment. You can also do a stock selection on the basis of a sector. So for example, I want to do a stock selection on the basis of automobile sector. So I can also do that. So for that, what I'll do, I'll just unselect all the sectors and I'll only select automobiles right here. I'll select only automobiles. Then I click on signal and then I click on the save button. So I click on the OK button. And after that, I'll just minimize this tab and I click on this refresh button. So once I click on the refresh button, let's see out of the total 36 Fox stocks under the automobile segment, how many stocks have generated the signal? So as you can see right now, so all the stocks are getting added right now. So it takes some time, let it load. So let's see out of the total 36 stocks under the automobile segment, how many stocks have generated the signals. So at present you can see there are approximately 18 stocks which have generated the signals, out of which 56% is showing a buy signal and 44% it is showing a short selling signal. Okay. So 56% is showing a buy signals out of the 18 stocks, 18 active signals and 44% is showing a short selling signals. Apart from that, you can also do one more thing. So again, I click on reset and save. You can also do on the stock selection on the base of segment, cash and future, indices, or else you can go for TGS picks. So on the TGS picks, there is best buy. So what do you mean by the best buy? These are those stocks which are good for buying as per the TGS software. So best sell, these are those stocks which are good for short selling. Then we are having TGS 20, trader's choice. Now what do you mean by the trader's choice? Trader's choice basically refers to what? So trader's choice is nothing but our clients. There are many clients who is using this software, who is using the terminal. What are the stocks they have selected the most? That comes under your trader's choice. Okay. These are the stocks which they have selected the most. That comes under your trader's choice. We are also having TGS 20. So TGS 20 is basically used by those people, those who don't have time to work on 70 signals or to watch 80 signals. They basically use TGS 20. So TGS 20 consists of buying signal as well as the selling or the short selling signal as well. So I'll select TGS 20 right now and I'll click on signal. I'll click on SMS and I'll click on email. So let's see how many stocks have generated signal. So further, I click on the refresh button right now. So let it load. So the total save signal, whatever the stocks you have selected, now the total save signal is 20. Okay, so the total save signal is 20. So let it load. We'll basically wait till it loads, right? So in this manner, you have to basically do a stock selection. Okay, so you have to follow this manner. You have to do a stock selection. So till it loads, we'll just wait for a few moments. So it is a very important feature that everybody should understand. It basically helps you to select the stocks as per your preference or select the one of the performing stocks such as TGS 20, Best Buy, Best Sell, all these things we'll get to know. So let it load. So as you can see, all the stocks are getting loaded right now. So once all the out of the, so the total save signal is how much? The total save signal is basically 20. So let's see out of the total 20 save signals, how many stocks are getting loaded right now. So as you can see out of the total 20 save signal, 13 stocks have generated the signals, out of which 69% is showing a buy signal and 31% is showing a short selling signal. So as you can see, if you are having any doubt, I hope everybody has understood, right? If any doubts, you can let me know. So if you are having any queries, any doubts, you can just contact to your TGS help desk. So the helpline number is basically 0226877 2310. And if you are having any queries regarding that, you can also mail it to us at the trade guide @motilaloswal.com. So thank you, everyone.